to a company from where the people had been hired.
So as a process compliance, you have to follow these 5 steps.
Right.
Whether the background verification is red, amber or green. You may be having like that.
Yeah, yeah.
Whether the background verification complies to those 6 steps, so you are green. If it doesn't comply with 6 steps, it complies to mandatory 3, you may be orange under the other 2.
Yeah, yeah.
That may be
very
close. So this is a standard practice you do in BG. But now let's take it step outside this 6 steps. What does a professional in BGV can do other than these 6 steps, which may not be expected by the customer, to enhance, which is a horizontally linked work for an HR professional in BGV role?
To authenticate, to give a
character
certificate for an employee.
Okay, think about it. See, most verify and assess some basic requirements of statutory part or a legal part, so that organizations are sure they are not having any criminal or an offender or someone who has a bad track record with an employer. That's what you want to ensure. Now in the process of doing this, what are you doing? You are exploring a person's profile. Now when you are exploring a person's profile, what other aspects of a person can you see?
I see a lot of diversity. Like every day I'm going through like hundreds of resumes in front of me, because when
hold on, you go through hundreds of resumes,
right?
But your eye only looks at those 6 things which the customer is asking.
Yeah.
Now as a professional, if you want to extrapolate the role, what all can you see in the profiles?
What are the options in the market? Like what are the salary structures which are being paid? What are the extra, you can say, focuses point for which they are being hired, and like salary structures basically, and what are the education qualifications, and from where they have started their career, and like I have done the background verification for VPs as well. So when I do a, you can say, cross-check of the details and information they have provided, I have seen like from where they have started their careers, basically from the executive level to being a VP of a company.
Excellent point. So when you look at this, one important element that you can actually always look at other than the 6 VGV parameters is the life history of an employee, the start point and the end point before he is hitting your new employer. So this experience can give you an understanding of the different competencies an individual has developed.
Right?
So one area for learning for you is how can you map the competencies of people?
Right.
Which the customer may not be asking you to do. So you can do competency mapping of an individual. You have to learn it yourself.
Right.
Some no one will tell you. But competency mapping is something which is beyond the current expected role of BGV. Now another area is profiling of people. These days, many organizations are using psychometric tools. This is a good opportunity for a person like you who is in BGV. Can I extend my experience and understand what type of profiles are today being used by the employer? For example, DISC is a profile. If many of you have heard about it, Thomas profiling mein karte hain. When you hire people, you hire them through a DISC assessment. Can a BGV person go and start understanding how does a Thomas profiling actually work before hiring someone? So remember one thing, it is up to you as a professional within your role horizontally how you can go and learn more. No employer will give you those options. You as a HR professional will have to yourself go and look what are the, you know, horizontal options available to me that as a professional I can go and learn. Otherwise your job will become stale, you will become very, very monotonous in your work and you don't want to leave this work quickly. But you have to create yourself opportunities within your role that what can be the aligned things that can help me to, you know, stay alive in the role.
Right, right. That is the reason I worked for a process associate for last 3 years. Because every day, every time I open a, you can say, ARS number and get a new thing to know about a person. I have some basic ethics, like I cannot disclose the things with other people and maintain a hygiene issue for other employees, even to my colleagues also. I cannot discuss the things with them. But there is something new every minute I start working on a new person. Like for me, it's a digits. But I, as an individual, being a literature person, I know now I'm profiling, I'm learning a new person. Who so is
think, think about, there are many options, like payroll you are teaching to do. Now payroll is a very monotonous job. If someone goes into the payroll, what is the job he or she has to do? Feeding of data and processing of the claims or salary or bills. It's a very monotonous job because employees will be submitting their bills, monthly attendance, the payroll person has to process it. Not the monotony in this. How can a payroll person break the monotony in this role? What are the allied jobs available? Allied competencies available? Can you even say that? What can this person do a little bit more?
Salary structuring.
Okay, excellent. Salary structuring. So he can be a person who can learn how the compensation actually works. Structure of compensation. Right? What else? Excellent point. Today, payroll professionals are highly getting digital and using the analytical techniques. And if a payroll person has to stay a payroll person all life, then no one can save him. But if a payroll person has to grow horizontally, analytics is another area that a person, and there are many tools today being used in HR analytics, especially in the payroll analytics. So when you are into HR, I tell this to everyone in HR, don't limit to what you are reading. Just to widen the horizon. HR person or a professional can be the best CEO of a company. If the HR person operates on the left side of the brain. Have you heard of left and right of brain?
Yes. Yeah.
The two brain theory, left brain and the right brain. Most of the HR professionals actually operate in the right brain domain. The moment HR professionals also start operating in the left brain domain, now they can be the best CEOs of the company. Okay? I have not charged him anything.